vision. Y'all still ain't clapping.
I'm videoing.
This is her last day.
Awesome.
Why some of our folks don't want to stay and lead in the community. Y'all, we got to recognize our folks and give them their flowers while they're alive, particularly on their last day. I was like, really, that's all we're going to do? So anyway, good morning. Today's theme is legacy of service. And we cannot have legacy without action. And we know that service is also action-based. But I really want to talk to you all about where we are in this country right now that requires activist service. For many of you who I may not know, and there are a lot of familiar faces, by the way, I received a text message this morning from my good friend, Angela Lyle, who I've known since preschool, who said her dad's birthday is today, and he is in the room, and I've known him for forever too. Where is he? Did he leave? Oh, there. Hey, happy birthday. yes, I promise that's my last shout out, but I did have to do that. When you have preschool friends, you do what you're supposed to do. For those of you who I don't know, I want to tell you a little bit about my background. Here's the cutoff for show. And I want you to understand a little bit more about my paradigm. I have an activist dad with a bullhorn. Yeah, all of you that just laughed know that he's got that joint. And my dad to this day, when people ask my dad how he's doing, he says, man, I'm just out here fighting this racism. Y'all laugh because he said that to you before. And it's something that he says that when I was younger, I was like, why can't you just say I'm fine? You know, I'm blessed, like some of my coaching church friends say, I'm blessed, it's too blessed to be stressed. But he said, man, I'm just out here fighting this racism. And you know, nowadays in 2017, I finally understand why he was saying that. Because now I'm just like, man, I'm just out here fighting this racism. You know? Thank you, Daddy. Shame, but no shame. And my father, he often brags about my first protest, which was when I was 2 years old, so I was not old enough to remember nor to decide that I was going. But he brags about it, I think because to him, a legacy of service was very important to instill in both me and my brother. My dad is such an activist that he named me after Angela Davis. Angela meaning bringer of truth, something that I strive to do every time I'm on CNN or on The Breakfast Club or whatever media appearance or speech that I have to give. And so with a father like that and a mother who also dedicated her life to higher education, who worked every day of her career, Dr. Andrea Rise, to create access to higher education system. My service was required and my activism not optional. So in high school, I went on to found a Black Student Union with my best friend, Leonetta Alijo. You gonna stand up? Because you grew up in an Urban League office, you're not gonna stand up, that's fine. And then my other best friend, Catherine Bush, you're not gonna stand up either, that's okay, who claims credit for founding the Black Student Union, but we got video that we just found, but we gonna let you be one of the original founding members. Like a deacon in a church, huh? Like that kind of thing. Sorry, Craig, you have me on a roll with church. And that founding of that BSU was symbolic for, I think, all of the things that we went on to do. Activism was in our veins because of our parents, because of our peers, our mentors. We were pushed to always try to make it better.